My game is mainly a survival game, and they all have day and night, but my game is bright as f***. Turning the sun off should do the trick. Okay, not really. But now the player cannot see what's around him, that's what I will be solving in this video. First, we must think of a way of storing light values for each block. For that, I'll store it using light layers. Each layer of blocks will have an associated light layer if that layer receives some kind of light. If it's all dark, we will not occupy unnecessary memory. Now that we have a way to store the light values, we can proceed to the next step, adding the actual light blocks, which is pretty simple. We create a new type of block and set a light intensity value, but now, when I place it, it's still all dark. We have to spread the light around the world. For that, when we place a block, we will have to compute the new light level of that block by checking its neighbors. For each neighbor, we get its light value and subtract the default falloff. This falloff allows to have lights up to 15 blocks long. If the final light value has changed, we must update the neighbors of that block and repeat the exact same process for each block update. This way, we end up spreading the light or darkness depending on the change we've made to the world. And we can't see any visual change yet. First, we must store it in the chunk mesh. The max light value is 7, so we need 3 bits. And the last step is to make a shader that takes that light value in the mesh and changes the color of the pixel in the fragment shader. And finally, we have light, but having only white light is a bit boring. Let's add RGB lights. For that, instead of sending 3 bits for the light value, we will use 5 bits for each channel. This way we have 32,768 different colors. Instead of 3 bits for the light value, we need then 15 bits, so we will use a short to store it. Notice that we have 1 bit left. Don't worry, we'll use it later. Now you can see we've got RGB lights working, and the blocks are also affected by the sunlight and shadows. Some people like the blocky lights and some other people prefer smoother lighting. So I will make a setting to switch between these modes easily. But of course, I need smooth lighting first. To implement smooth lighting, we have to compute a light value for each vertex of a face. And the fragment shader will do the linear interpolation between them. To compute the light value for each vertex, we must check its neighbors. Let's take as an example this vertex. The neighbors we must check are the ones I'm showing you right now. And then we proceed to compute the average of the neighbor light values. Doing this exact same process for each vertex, we get the smooth lighting we were looking for. But we can see weird shadows when a block is near a solid one, because a solid block stores a light value of 0. But do you remember that bit that was left from storing the RGB value of a light? Well, we can use it to check whether it's a solid or a transparent block. This way, we compute the average light value of the neighbors for a vertex, and if the neighbor is solid, we will simply ignore it for the average. And now, we removed those weird shadows we previously had. One more task is to be able to set the amount of light that a block occludes. We specify a filter value to each block, so some blocks block more or less light. But what happens when our block is a vertical slab, for example? We must also block the light depending on the mesh of a block. That means directional light filtering blocks. The vertical slab, for example, only blocks light horizontally in the set axis. To specify that, we will store it in bits, 1 bit for each direction in each axis. The order will be positive Z, positive X, negative Z, and negative X, and then positive Y and negative Y. This way, we can easily rotate the direction by shifting 1 bit to the left each 90 degrees. So now, in the light spread algorithm, when checking a neighbor, we will also check if the direction from the neighbor to the block being checked is blocked or not, with a logical AND. Okay, now we can place light blocks to light our house. But what if the player is exploring at night? The player must be able to equip a torch and see what's happening around. The solution? Dynamic point lights. The player, when having a torch or another light item, will illuminate its surroundings. The shader will compute the final light value depending on the max value it receives from the different sources, the directional light or the sun, the dynamic point lights, and the light value from the mesh. This way, we get torches and light blocks that only light the surroundings at night. And with all of these features, we can conclude the lighting of my game, more or less. What is left is to illuminate the entities depending on the light, but we will leave that for when we have entities. To sum up, we ended up with dynamic lights, RGB lights, and day-night global light. Thank you for watching, and see you in my next video.